Recent years saw a rise of a new class of indie games called AA. Games such as Hellblade, Plague Tale: Innocence, The Ascent, or Kena: Bridge of Spirits, just to name a few. And the new addition to this list is Stray, a dystopian sci-fi cut simulator game, aims to deliver high fidelity visuals with stunning art direction. And just like most other AA games, it's powered by a Unreal Engine 4. But unfortunately, it doesn't provide a lot of graphic settings. And even with that, and as usual, we'll break down each setting's visuals and performance. So without any further ado, let's get going. As I said before, this game doesn't offer a lot when it comes to settings. In fact, it only has 4 if we ignore motion blur and sharpness. But one setting changes more than one visual aspect. I'm talking about effects quality, which controls first screen space reflections like here, where only medium and high have reflections. And the second thing which this setting changes are volumetrics, like here with the light shaft, where both low and medium looks flickery and low res compared to high. Also in this game, volumetrics scales with the resolution you're playing at, where here 1080p high volumetrics don't look as clean as 4K high. Effects quality also looks like it controls the quality of shading. Now, having control of a lot of things come with a big performance impact. Going from low to medium drop FPS by 9%, but to high a big 38%. Here the only thing that you'll notice during gameplay are reflections. That's why in my opinion, medium is the best option. Shadow quality is next. This one is straightforward. It changes the resolution of shadows, as you can see here. We're going from low to medium, slightly improve the quality with around 2% hit to performance, and to high 4%. Shadows in this game don't cost a lot, and since you won't often see visible large shadows like this one, because most of the game take place at night, any option here will work fine. The difference in texture quality is really hard to notice, as you can see here between low and high. And the VRAM consumption is low in this game. Even at 4K, the max usage I saw was around 4.7 GB. So you shouldn't worry about textures, just keep it on high. Finally, we have mesh quality, which controls the geometric details of objects far away, like here, where you can see that this window's cage is completely drawn in high, unlike low where it looks incomplete. Performance-wise, going from low to high costs around 2%. Now, similar to shaders and global illumination, you won't notice the difference in normal gameplay, and also the performance hitch is negligible, so any option here will work fine. So, to wrap this up, Stray offers great visuals and the gorgeous art direction really help with the presentation. And the game performed great, but if you need extra performance, the first setting and maybe the only one you should tweak is effects quality, which has big performance impact. And my optimized setting, it just set effects to medium and enjoy the game. And if you need more, you can put it on low and tweak shadows as well. And that was it. Thank you so much for watching and for your time. Like or dislike the video. Don't forget to subscribe and hit the notification bell for future videos. Feel free to leave a comment down below and I'll see you in the next one.